An unprecedented event at the White House this morning. President Trump making his way through a mob of reporters for an impromptu interview on Fox and Friends. The president then unloading on top FBI brass over the inspector general's damning report.
The top people were horrible. You look at what happened. They were plotting against my election. The report, the IG report, was a horror show. You go into the FBI and take a poll of the real FBI, not the scum on top, not Comey and that group of people that are total thieves. I think that the report yesterday, maybe more importantly than anything, it totally exonerates me.
The president also taking aim at Special Agent Peter Strzok. Even more of his anti-Trump texts were exposed by the IG.
I am amazed that Peter Strzok is still at the FBI, and so is everybody else that read that report. And I'm not even talking about the report. I'm talking about long before the report. Peter Strzok should have been fired a long time ago.
And President Trump hammering fired FBI Director James Comey.
They just seem like very criminal acts to me. What he did was criminal. What he did was a terrible thing to the people. What he did was so bad in terms of our Constitution, in terms of the well-being of our country. What he did was horrible. Should he be locked up? Let somebody make a determination. I think Comey was the ringleader of this whole, you know, den of thieves.
All right, so obviously strong words coming from the president this morning, an impromptu conference there, speaking with our Steve Ducey, and the other Ducey was there as well, right?
Yeah.
The Ducey sandwich.
Ducey sandwich, yes. This is what
Ducey
we were
landed
today.
The big one.
The Ducey Deuce.
Yeah, you just have to stand outside the White House and have the Fox News mic flag. He'll just come right out. I thought it was, interesting interview from the president. He had a lot to say, I think, but most importantly, what he said about Strzok, the guy should not be there. I mean, and Strzok and his compatriots, some of this disgusting thing. I mean, it sounds like they're members of the resistance, the way they talk about Trump supporters. They said they're all middle class, uneducated, lazy POSs. You know what that stands for. And calls them retarded. Mm-hmm. And when you combine that with, you know, we'll stop him, you know, Peter Strzok saying we'll stop him to Lisa Page, there's not a single pro-Trump text. There's not any anti-Hillary text. It's all against the president of the United States. So when the IG report comes out and says, oh, there's no political bias, there's extreme political bias. Well, I don't see how they could say that with a straight face. It was anti-Trump from the jump, and you understand why when you look at James Comey. He knew Loretta Lynch and her boss, Barack Obama, didn't want Hillary Clinton charged. He's not going to stop the first female president from taking office. Everybody thought Hillary was going to win. And that's why a lot of the FBI agents were intimidated and they didn't want to go too tough on her, because they thought when she gets into the Oval, you know, she's going to crack down on them. And, you know, Hillary's very vindictive. She'll probably do that. They knew she was going to be president, and that's why the fix was in. And then once Trump got the nomination, they turned the screws to him and treated him and his people very unfairly. And the way Comey, you know, behaved during this whole time, he used private email. He exonerated Hillary. He changed the language of the law to make it about intent. Intent had nothing to do with it. And there was leaking going on everywhere. Everybody was leaking. So this report justifies Trump's firing of James Comey and pretty much exonerates the president with regard to what he's been saying about the Hillary Clinton investigation. It was crooked and remains even more crooked.
Jesse, what Jim Comey is criticized for in the IG report, the things he did going out in July and having that press conference, going out in October and talking about reopening the investigation, those things all helped Donald Trump. They did not hurt Hillary.
I actually think he saved her because he could have charged her and taken her totally out of play, and Bernie would have been the nominee. Let me counter back, though.
There are a lot of FBI officers. I would actually argue that most of law enforcement tends to lean conservative, and that if the FBI in this deep state...
Have you heard them talk? Don't sound like conservatives,
well,
these people talking.
Let me finish, Jesse. If this deep state law enforcement FBI group wanted to take down Donald Trump, why didn't they leak the fact that his campaign was under investigation?
They didn't think he was going to win.
But they could
have. That's when all the leaks came out afterwards.
If their goal was to take him down, Which I don't think it was, no, but I'm following this conspiracy theory.
The goal was to help Hillary.
Why wouldn't they do that?
The goal was to help Hillary.
Why didn't they leak that Trump
because
was under
the goal?
It did leak to the Times in October.
But the goal changed. They were quite certain of a determinative outcome, which was that Hillary Clinton was going to be the next president of the United States. So when it became apparent that that was not going to be the case, then they shifted tactics and they moved towards a direct focus on undermining the candidacy of Donald Trump and ultimately the president, someone duly elected, to try to undo it. So, Abby, you see this going on. This is just part of what's going to be coming forward in terms of an IG report, right? So you have those revelations, but keep in mind that those documents and all the voluminous amount to pages that we saw, those are still redacted, and by Ron Rosenstein, who's someone who's right in the middle of this sort of like nefarious circle of malfeasance.
Right. No, it's a great. There's still a lot of questions to be asked here. You guys are going back and forth in the politics and who it helped and who it hurt, but isn't the problem that there were politics to begin with within the department, within the FBI? The sad thing to me is you've got over 100,000 people that work within DOJ. Many of them are great people. The president pointed that out this morning in that interview, and I think it's an important point to make because you feel for them in this moment, the ones that are doing their job, that aren't political. There's going to be a hearing with Michael Horowitz on Monday and Tuesday, I believe, on the House and in the Senate. And I think the big questions, Kimberly, will be, does action need to be taken now on not just Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, but there are other agents, as you mentioned, Agent 1, Agent 2, Agent 3, who said terrible things about President Trump and the people that support President Trump. So where does this end? Are we supposed to look at this report and say, oh, you know what, that's pretty bad, let's all move on? Or do we learn from this and actually take some real action here?
Absolutely.
Should there be consequences?
And that's the question, and that's what the president is saying. You know, continue the investigation, find out what action, if any, needs to be determined, what needs to happen to Jim Comey. Greg, you know, hashtag.
Can we just first address what happened this morning, which was the presser in general? This is the actual transcript. I had it printed out. It's 50 pages. This is, the media should stop and thank Donald Trump for the most transparent president I think we've had in history. The guy walks out and talks for 51 minutes about everything. Forget the IG. He's the OG.
How bored it would be if it were Hillary Clinton?
Oh, my God. No.
She went like 300 days on
No. She need a break.
Without a presser.
She need a break.
She passed out before she reached the lawn. Yeah.
There's no such thing in Donald Trump's world as no comment. If you just let him go, at some point, he will say your name. We saw that with Stuart Varney. I mean, if he just keeps talking, he will say, you know, kittens are just like unicorns, but smaller. So that's my take on the actual presser, which I thought was fantastic, entertaining, and it's going to give us three segments today on a Friday. Let's talk about the big deal here. It's Strzok and Page and their texts. I hate parsing people's texts because I feel like I'm reading something that wasn't meant for public view, and it could be done to me. 90% of my texts are careless and hyperbole. Half the time, I'm kind of buzzed when I'm texting people.
They're frightening. Take my word for it.
However, having said that, when you read a fellow investigator saying they will stop Trump, if that's not political bias, what would constitute political bias? I mean, thinking that there's almost no step beyond what he is saying short of advocating violence or an overthrow or something. I mean, it's like, what would you have to say that's beyond that? That's the limit. So I think it's a bit strange. I mean, I think you can interpret it and say like, oh, it's just two lovers trying to impress each other, two, you know, heroes in their own love story. But when you look at that, man, it's, pretty.
And let's remember who he was. He was the lead investigator for the Clinton email probe. He interviewed all of Hillary's people. He was the one that traveled to England to talk to the quote-unquote spy. He was the one that officially opened up the counterintelligence investigation into Donald Trump. He was the one that interviewed Mike Flynn. Yeah. And then he was handpicked to go onto Mueller's team.
And why
is
that?
So this guy is not a small ball player. This is the key player in this investigation, in both investigations, and he's out there talking about we need to stop him from becoming president, and now that he is president, we need to do something about it.
And now that's why Trey Gowdy, if you're watching Special Report last night, said that this Mueller probe is tainted, and no matter what comes out of it, should we take it seriously?
That's because, the causal nexus.
Because, as you said, Peter Strzok was one of the top people originally on that investigation, and you heard Rudy Giuliani this morning. He said, we're not going to cooperate anymore. He's doubling down even more, saying we are not going to do that sit down between Mueller and President Trump. Who knows how this ends? This may end up going all the way to the Supreme Court. But right. You can't argue, Marie Harf, that the early days of this investigation certainly had was tainted.
So I think that the text messages are awful and they give the appearance of bias, which is what the inspector general said. The inspector general also said they did not find any evidence that it impacted the investigation.
And the Clinton investigation.
And they also said that Peter Strzok at times advocated for actually tougher action against the Clinton people, including the use of subpoenas, than other people on the team, and that he was not the sole decision maker on anything related to the investigation. So I agree these texts give a very bad appearance of political bias, and it was stupid and they shouldn't have done it. But we have to also follow what the IG said in terms
of evidence. But it's more nefarious.
We have to follow the IG where they say there is no evidence this impacted investigative decisions, and in fact Strzok argued for tougher action against the Hillary people. That's what the IG says, Jesse.
He was the key player in downgrading the language when he said, when he wrote the exoneration letter, reckless or not, he was the one that downgraded into careless. The other thing he did when they got their hands on all the Anthony Weiner emails, he was the one that sat on them for a month, and they didn't funnel their way up to Comey until right before the election.
Which hurt Hillary.
Very suspicious.
It hurt Hillary.
It doesn't matter who it helps or hurts,
well,
though.
Well, but it does if you're
it's
accusing
just the
him
fact they're
of political
not doing
bias.
Their job
they're
and they're working outside
yes.
protocol.
I agree, but if you're accusing him of political bias in favor of Hillary,
he is biased. He hates Donald Trump. He hates him.
It's in writing. We don't need to speculate. It's there from beginning to end that they had a specific intended purpose of what they wanted the outcome to be, which does taint the overall investigation that Mueller is doing because the key players are involved, those that have already been compromised, including Jim Comey.
Peter Strzok still has a job.
Yeah. Shocking and shameful.